nook and cranny of each government office and assign a reality TV camera on each public official, maybe we could lessen corruption and shed light on secrecy. But that is not possible. It is impractical and maybe illegal. The FOI is the next best thing. It gives citizens the flashlight to focus light and the camera to take snapshots of how government operates, spends public funds, and makes transactions, among others. Day to day, though, Filipinos just want to make government work for them. We just want information on how to deal with government. Government has long been compiling information from citizens: income, census, car ownership, home ownership, taxes. It is about time for government to provide information. The passage of FOI is long overdue. Congressman Oscar Orbos filed House Bill 1805 on August 31, 1992. To illustrate the long wait, Senator Poe was nursing her firstborn son, 4 months old at that time. Senator Ejercito was a new college graduate. Senator Angara was a business reporter. Senator Enrile already finished his second term as senator. And also in 1992, we almost had a president by the name of Miriam Defensor Santiago. Now is the perfect time for Congress, the next perfect time for Congress, to pass the FOI law. Citizens are taking action over the PDAF scandal and demanding that steps be taken to prevent the scam from happening again. Even President Aquino is said to be agreeing already to make it a priority measure. The internet and social media. It is important to note that the first FOI bill filed in 1992 antedates the Philippines' first internet connection. We first had the first FOI bill before the Philippines had its first internet connection in March 1994. We are now a nation of 35 million internet-connected citizens with more than 30 million